Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 in Peru. If you have been following along, open the file 00_034_DIAB where you save it. You can also download this file on the website, or you can follow along with your own file or just sit down and watch the video. Go to the Quick Access toolbar and click the Save As icon. This will bring the Save Drawing As dialog box. Rename this file as 00_035_DIAB where you save it. Click the Save button. Go to the navigation bar and select the Orbit command. Orbit into this area and zoom in to get a clear view. Go to the 3D Tools tab. Solid Edit panel and click the down arrow after the Solid Edit. Select the Copy Edge command. At the Select Object prompts, go to the Selection panel and click the Edge filter. Zoom in into this area and select this edge. Hold down your Shift key and your middle mouse button. Select this edge. Press Enter. At the Specify Base Point prompts, click at this vertex. At the specified second point of displacement, click the same vertex. Press Escape to get out of the command. Go to the Edge panel and change the L filter to no filter. Go to the Visual Style control and click Realistic. Select 2D wireframe. Select this line, and the frame of this window. The frame of this other window. Right click, isolate objects. Change the visual style back to realistic. Hold down your Shift key and middle mouse button and orbit around. Change your visual style to 2D wireframe. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel, and click this down arrow. Select the copy edge command. Go to the selection panel and change to edge filter. Move the mouse cursor and select this edge. Press Enter. Use the endpoint object snapper and click to into this area. Click into this area again. Select the copy option. Move the mouse cursor down. Click this edge. Press Enter. At the specified base point prompt, click on this area and click again. Press Escape to get out of the command. Change the view to realistic. Now change it back to 2D wireframe. Select the window, this object. Right click, hide object. Right click the UCS and select the object option. Hover the mouse cursor into this line and click. Right click the UCS again. Rotate axis, X axis. Move the mouse cursor so that the Y axis perpendicular points at the top of the screen and click. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel and select the Offset command. For the offset distance, type 6 inches on your keyboard and press Enter. Select this line and offset it up. Select this line and offset it up. Press Escape. Go to the View Control and select Right. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel and select the Fillet command. Type M on your keyboard and press Enter. Select this line, 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 this line. Press Escape to get out of the command. Go to the Home tab, Modify panel and select the Trim command. Press Enter. Hold down the Shift key and extend this line, this line, this line, this line. Now release the Shift key and trim off this line and this line. Press Escape to get out of the panel. Hold down your Shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Now go to the Home tab, Draw panel and select the rectangle command. Start the rectangle at this corner to this corner. Press Enter to repeat the rectangle command. Start the rectangle from this corner to this corner. Now select the whole thing, zoom in into this area and deselect the rectangle. press delete on your keyboard to delete the lines. Select this line and delete it. Use a window selection to select the entire object. Zoom in into this area, hold down your shift key, select to deselect rectangle. Hit delete to delete the object. Now use a window selection and delete the remaining one. Select the two rectangle. Go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. Move the mouse cursor into this direction and type 2 feet on your keyboard. Press enter. Right click into the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Go to the visual style control and click the 2D visual style, select realistic. Go to the 3D tools tab, follow the edit panel, and select the press tool command. Add a select object or bounded area prompt. Click at the top of this solid and move the mouse cursor. Snap it into this, the vertex of this solid. Repeat the same thing over here and snap it into this point. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the layer property. Let's create a new layer. Let's name this layer window C. Click the color switches and change the color to the index color 167. Click OK. Close the dialog box. Now select this solid and move it to the window C layer. Press escape to deselect the object. Go to the quick access toolbar and select the match property. At the select source object prompt, select this solid. At the select destination object prompt, select this solid. Press escape to get out of the command. Now we need to separate this solid from this other solid. To do that, let's draw a temporal line first. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the line command. Add a specified first point object form. Hover the mouse cursor into this area and move it in this direction. Type 4 feet on your keyboard, press enter. Now move the line into this direction and click. Move up and type 22 feet. Press enter. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the 3D tools tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. Select this line, press enter, and type P on your keyboard, press enter. Select this line as the path. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel, and select the slide command. At the select object point, select this solid, press enter, type S on your keyboard, and press enter. Select the surface, press enter. Press enter again to repeat the slice command. Select the solid, press enter, type S, press enter. Select the surface, press enter. Press enter to repeat the slice command again. At the select object prompt, select the foundation, press enter, type S on your keyboard, press enter, and select the surface, press enter. Select the slice command again. At the select object prompt, select the slab and this slab. Press enter. Type S on your keyboard, press enter. Select this surface, press enter, press enter. Go to the quick access toolbar and select the match property command. At the select source object prompt, select this object. At the select destination object prompt, select this solid, this solid, this solid, this solid, and this solid. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this surface and hit delete. This surface and hit delete. It seems that there is a gap in this foundation. So the slice command reveals this gap clearly. To get rid of this gap, we're going to press pull this gap. Go to the 3D tools, solid edit panel, and select the press pull command. At the select object prompt, select the face of this solid, and move the mouse cursor and snap to this vertex. Select this face and move the mouse cursor and snap into this vertex. Repeat the same thing until, if you have the same problem, repeat the same thing until you get rid of everything. Hold on your shift key and orbit around. Zoom in into this area. Now go to the 3D Twister solid edge panel and click the down arrow. Select the copy edge command. Go to the selection panel and click the down arrow. Select the edge filter. Select the edge of this solid. Hold on your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit and select the edge of this solid. Press enter. At a specifying base point prompt, click into the vertex, into this vertex, the vertex of this solid, and click it again. Press escape to get out of. Now change your visual style to 3D wireframe and change the selection filter to new filter. Now zoom in into this area, select this line and this line, and select the window. Right click, isolate objects. Go to the 3D Twister solid edge panel and click the down arrow. Select the copy edge command. Go to the selection panel and change to edge filter. Hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit. Select this edge and this edge. Press enter. At the specified base point or displacement point, click into this area. At the specified second point or displacement point, click the same area. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the view control, click the custom view and select the font option. Go to the home tab, modify panel and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 6 inches on your keyboard and press enter. Select this line and offset it up. Select this line, move if done and type 4 inches. Press enter to offset the line. Go to the home tab, modify panel and click this down arrow. Select the extend command. Press enter. Extend this object. Go to the home tab, draw panel and select the rectangle command. Select the rectangle from this corner to this corner. Press enter. Pick this endpoint to this endpoint. Go to the 3D tool start selection panel and select new filter. Select this two line and hit delete on your keyboard. Now zoom in into this area. Select this line, use a crossing window and this. Now hold down your shift key. Select this line, this rectangle and hit the delete key on your keyboard. Go to the navigation bar and click the orbit command. Zoom in and orbit this drawing out. Now select this, go to the 3D Twister tab, modeling panel and select the extrude command. Type 2 feet on your keyboard, press enter. Select this, go to the 3D Twister tab, modeling panel and select the extrude command. Move the mouse cursor and type 1 foot on your keyboard, press enter. Right click into the drawing area, isolate and object isolation. Go to the visual style control, click the 2D wireframe and select realistic. Go to the home tab, drop an and select the line command. At a specified first point prompt, start a line from this corner and move your mouse cursor into this direction. When the mouse cursor go past the wall, click. Move in this direction and click. Press escape to get out of the command. Start the line command again. At a specified start point prompt, move the mouse cursor and start a line from this point, click. Use the perpendicular object snap to complete your line. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the 3D tool tab, modeling panel and click the down arrow next, select box. At the specified first corner point, use the endpoint of this object snap and click. At the specified other corner point prompt, select the endpoint of this vertex and click. It will complete the box command. Now, since your visual set is 3D wireframe, select this solid, hold down the control and shift key, type C on your keyboard, and use the at a specified base point from use the endpoint of the trap and click into this area. Press escape. Now, go to the 3D tools tab, solid edge panel, and select the subtract command. Select this solid, press enter, and select this solid, press enter to end the command. Hold down your control key and type G on your keyboard. At the specified base point point, click at the endpoint of this line. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel, and select the subtract command. Select the slab, press enter, and select this solid, press enter. Go to the visual style control, click the 2D wireframe, and select realistic. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel, and select the press P command. At the select object or bounded area prompt, hover the mouse cursor into this area and move the mouse cursor at the top of the building. Click on this face. And move the mouse cursor up. Click. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the 3D tools tab, solid edit panel, and select the slice command. At the select object prompt, select this object. Press enter. Type S on the keyboard and press enter and select this surface. Click this solid. Go to the quick access toolbar and select the match property. At the select source object prompt, select this object. At the select destination object prompt, select this object. Press escape to get out of the command. Go to the quick access toolbar and select the match property command again. Select this solid and this solid. Press escape to get out of it. Right click the UCS and click the select world. Go to the navigation bar and click the zoom extent button. Go to the visual, the view control, and select SW isometric. Select SE isometric. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save button. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your friend. If you have any question or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue on this series or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.